at the beginning of the year. This was my first ever Triple Crown. At the end of the year, this was actually my eighth Triple Crown of 2022. This is the biggest trophy I have ever received. I'm Annalie Waters, I'm 16 years old, and I'm the number one female professional pickleball player. Pickleball has become so popular because anyone can play. Any age can play and any skill level can play. You can have fun, you can be competitive. It's just a sport for everyone.
With the first pick in the 2023 Major League Pickleball Draft, the New Jersey Fives select Annalie Waters.
She's so good everywhere on the court. There is no weakness in this young lady.
Annalie was unquestionably the number one pick, I think, for everybody. In the draft, people are picking men and women, and to have a number one pick that was a female player and to have more women's picks in the top 10 than men was really remarkable and says something about pickleball. She is a young phenom, ranked number one in the world, both in singles, mixed doubles, and women's doubles. She is the most dominant player in the game.
At the Tournament of Champions, I won the most or had the most points in that tournament. I was ranked the number one women's singles player at 14 years old. I feel like the achievement that I'm most proud of didn't actually happen this year. It happened in 2019 when I won nationals with my mom. I remember after we won the match, she like jumped and then she started like running around the court and I was like chasing her, like wanting to hug her and like celebrate with her.
Look how excited they are.
Waters and Waters.
It was our first huge tournament that we won together. I think I had an out of body experience. We had reached a goal that, you know, that we had set.
I never thought of pickleball as a job, but at the same time, like I guess it kind of is. It's a very fun job, especially this year. A lot of big companies have gotten into the sport. I've also seen a big growth in like celebrity pickleball. I've had a lot of sponsorship opportunities. I have an agent now. I am so young, and to, you know, learn as many things as I'm learning and, you know, be a part of sponsorship deals and learning about contracts. Sometimes I'll see like the checks that come in and I'm like, save it, I'm saving it, I'm putting it in the bank. I try not to spend my money. You see someone like Michael Jordan who can like design their own shoe, and then I'm sponsored by Fila, so I'm kind of designing a shoe with them. It's just kind of cool that I can be kind of grouped into like an athlete that's making their own shoe, which is amazing.
Annalie and I started playing pickleball the exact same day, the exact same second. We evacuated our home in Florida due to a hurricane, and we went to visit my father, who lived in Pennsylvania.
So he asked us, you know, do you want to go play pickleball? And at first we were kind of like, no, because we didn't know what it was, and I was pretty young, I think I was 10.
So we thought it was an older person's sport, but we went, and from the moment we stepped on the court, we were hooked.
First time I hit the ball, I was like in love with the sport. We played like 3 times a day for like 2 weeks straight while we were up there. From when I first started playing, I played with my grandfather and my mom, and I can still play with my grandfather and my mom.
It's fun, but it's also embarrassing. As I got older and older, obviously I got worse and worse, and as she got older, she got better and better. Unfortunately, at the previous national tournament, Lee was injured, so when Annalie was going into a finals match, she had nobody to warm her up, so I actually warmed her up. I really don't know the outcome of the success of the warm-up, but she won. So I guess I did something right.
Annalie and I play a few times a week. Some of that is rec playing, some of that is drilling. Watching Annalie compete, she's feisty, she's the animal, she's an absolute beast on the court. I'm a full-time student, but I am also a full-time professional pickleball player, so hopefully I'm gonna make a career out of this.
You got that right on his mic? Can you send it to me? Yeah. When I'm home, I'll usually play pickleball 5 days a week. I usually drill like 2 times a week, and then I'll play rec games 3 times a week. If I'm drilling, it's around 2 hours, and if I'm playing rec games, it can be anywhere from like 2 to 3 hours. And I'm usually in the gym 5 days a week as well. I would say average in a day, I'm working out like 4 hours. And even on my off days, I'm doing either some kind of cardio or walking.
She started off as a soccer player and tennis player, converted I think at 11 when she learned the game, went pro at 12. Lightning quick hands, great court awareness, great court coverage.
I have a lot of different skill sets from different sports. For soccer, it's definitely like the footwork and the fast sprinting and the lateral movement and stuff. For tennis, it's definitely the form. The form is very similar if you watch tennis and pickleball, but there is a big difference between like strategy in pickleball and tennis, so I had to learn that.
Annalie and I had come from tennis, and the minute I stepped on the court, I just wanted to hit the ball hard. And everybody kept telling us, like, you're not playing correctly. This isn't how you play. You have to hit soft. You have to hit these dinks. But it's just what came so true to me and Annalie was this power game. So we just continued with our game, and the next thing you know, we were winning national championships at the pro level, and we were known for our aggressive style of play.
A lot of people ask the question, like, how do you guys play on the court together? Isn't it hard that she's your mom and that she's your daughter? Isn't the dynamic weird? But I feel like for us, it's the opposite. Like, we have this mother-daughter intuition where we know where the other one's gonna be on the court. And if we miss a shot, we know the other person's not gonna be mad at us. So we just feel like, you know, we can play how we wanna play. We don't have to worry about disappointing our partner, because no matter what happens on the court, we're a family, and that's what families do. They stick together. I travel with not only my mom, but also my dad. Win or lose, me and my family always go out to eat. And I have a really special bond with my grandma. She's been homeschooling me from 3rd grade on. Now I'm in 11th grade. Even before I started playing pickleball, I was homeschooling, and it just really worked out because I couldn't travel and do all the things that I'm doing with pickleball right now.
Becoming a professional athlete, I'm so proud of Annalie. Her coaches in her other sports have always told us what an athlete she was and what potential she had, but you still don't necessarily go to like, oh, professional athlete.
This is probably a very futuristic goal, but I want to play pickleball in the Olympics one day. I grew up watching the Olympics, and I think it would be really cool to represent my country. And I also want to see pickleball grow like in other countries. I also want to see pickleball grow in like high schools and get younger kids involved. And that's something that I'm working on now. So in the beginning of this year, one of my goals was to get a triple crown, and I ended up getting 8 this year, which was amazing. If I've accomplished a goal, there's still something better you can do. So I feel like next year I'm gonna try to get 9 triple crowns, which might be difficult, but I'm gonna try to do it. I'm just really, you know, enjoying the ride, and I wanna keep going as long as I can.
When we came home, we decided we were going to get a ping pong table. Well, I think we played about 2 weeks before Annalie got so good that nobody wanted to play with her anymore, and I don't think we've played ping pong since.
稍等一下，不要离开，让我们来看看 Anna 在巡回赛里面一盘非常精彩的逆风翻盘局。画面这一方先发球的就是我们的天才少女安娜哦，她名字听起来有点熟悉亲切的感觉，因为她叫 Anna Lee Waters。三个字都很简单，而且他有个利，不是姓李哦，发音是跟利是一样的。然后呢，他的对手呢是桃红色这位衣服，叫做 Paris Todd。Paris 也是一个非常强劲的对手。那你看他们从一开始的发球、抽球都非常强劲，其实都是想要把对方压在底线。结果让 Todd 接近了 Kitchen 之后，安娜就只能一直接 Todd 的杀球，哇！接着竟然走回 Kitchen 呢、欸，哇 ！OK， 这个穿越很漂亮，这打的一个安娜猝不及防。啊，你看这精彩回顾，哇哦！那个安娜以为 Todd 要往右边打，结果他突然变向打了一个左边，一个很漂亮的一个变向。第二盘哦， 现在换 Paris 的发球得分了。皮克球的比赛，单打比赛是这样哦，要把发球抢回到自己身上，然后再得分，才能够真的得到分数。可以看到左上角的这个积分板上面哦，那个 Paris Todd， 你看在他背后有看板，他写14人哦，他世界排名第14，所以 Anna 写一什么意思呢？没有错，他就是世界排名第一。他这不只是女子单打世界排名第一，他的男女混双还有女子双打都是世界排名第一，这是很可怕的一件事情啊。这简直就是怪物般的存在，太厉害了！而且他才16岁，从12岁开始打巡回赛，打到现在打4年，就获得了三样世界第一的成绩。哦，前面的影片也有介绍到哦，他的三冠王。什么叫三冠王呢？一个赛事里面有男子单打、女子单打、男女混双跟女子双打，还有男子双打，总共是五样不同的赛事。而他女生能参加的就是女子单打、男女混双以及女子双打，他参加的三个都拿冠军，所以叫三冠王。一个赛事里面拿到三冠王是真的真的很难很难的。而有看到前面的影片可以知道他拿了几个，他拿了一年拿了八个三冠王，欸，太夸张了。好，现在回到我们的赛事场上，一样留让我们透的发球。哦，这球是安娜斜角杀个透的措手不及吗？这个美国的户外跟台湾的户外不一样，美国的户外其实很舒服，因为干燥嘛。台湾的户外太潮湿，所以一下就很湿了。啊，这一球挂网没有爬过来，所以在美国打户外是很舒服的事情哦。当然啦，正中午太阳很大的时候还是太晒，但是稍微晚一点它就凉了，不像台湾夏天到晚上九点。不要说九点，可能到十二点出门都还是热的。我们看到安娜这个回击又挂网，因为回击她出现蛮多次的挂网，都是因为她还在调整那个高度。其实球刚刚好过网的高度是最好的，所以在这个界限之间呢，挂网跟过网其实就真的只是一线之隔哦。这一球好像安娜出界了哦。对，所以偷的又得分了。看这些高手打球真的是很享受，而且感觉可以学到很多东西。哇，你看这一球，这一球，这个出界了，出界了。哦，不然这一球实在是很漂亮，这个完全没办法救的。所以得分跟出界也是一线之隔。打匹克球呢，其实会输呢，都是在于自己的失误多，大部分都是输在自己的失误。你说真的是对方杀到你完全没办法接的球，真的其实少输。自己的出界、自己的挂网其实是占绝大部分。你们可以下次自己去打球的时候，可以算算，是不是都是输在自己的失误上面？哦，你看这分数变了哦，所以这应该是两局把它合在一起。那我们现在从这局开始看，已经2-7了。透的这个左右吊球真的很强。Tina 只能哇，这一球碰到网子 ，lucky 啊。Anna 回球挂网。现在比分来到8-2，由透的桃红色透的领先。这一球回击挂网，这是一个简单的非收获性失误哦， 好，那回到画面这一边的 Anna 发球，他们的发球呢，就是强而有力，简洁有力，都刚好过网而已。可以看到，哇，这球真的很漂亮。Anna 把对方死死的摁在底线上，对方不敢轻易的往前走进 kitchen， 因为太害怕 Anna 的暴力搓球，突然掉个小球根本来不及跑。Anna 完全是力量型打法，他跟他妈都是力量型打法，他们的打法比较少掉小球在 kitchen 的，他们都是走力量型的，这个在前面的访问有提到，真的很可怕，这个力量我觉得不输给男生。你看这抽球的力道，哇，都往底线压啦。我觉得这个是往底线压是很难的，因为把人压在底线，然后你又往底线压球，这个人呢，因为打皮克球会有惯性，会想要上 kitchen， 所以你不自觉的脚步会往前踏两步，所以你球只要落底线哦，那个位置都很难打，代表那个落球的地点哦，大概都在你脚的附近，那是非常难打的。如果你可以练成哦，把那个落球点都落在脚跟附近的话，那你就超强，因为那是最最最最最难打的。现在场上分数来到9-4，由桃红色的 Paris Toad 领先。现在发球，看看 Anna 怎么回应后续哦。在这个大比分落后下，这个抽球太精彩了，这完全没有办法救。你看 Anna 对于她的上限，就是逼近 kitchen 的这个攻击非常有自信，也非常有威胁性。继续看这一球啊，挂网。Anna 拿回球权之后又挂网，现在球权又回到 Toad 身上。其实这挂网呢，代表他球都打得很低，他都想要打刚刚好在网子上面，这是最难接的球，没错。所以呢，过网跟挂网其实就是一线之隔。所以你看 Anna 的这个打法，每一球都非常极具威胁性，所以只有他自己可以打败自己。他如果失误多的话，就造成今天的比数现在一个很悬殊到了4-4。那我们Toad已经到赛末点了，我们看看这一局可不可以顺利拿下来啊？但是我们天才少女 Anna 应该不会那么容易妥协的、哦。啊，这一球判断出界，很漂亮。我们的 Anna 拿回发球权。好，好打一个轻轻的发球。Anna 又在用长力的抽球，哇！想要攻一个左侧的压线球，但是这一球应该被裁判叫 out， 所以球权又回到 Paris 身上。Paris 再度经历赛末点，那我们看一下 Paris 发球，中规中矩的哦。虽然 Paris 是，哇，这一球太漂亮，突然往前掉个小球。啊，然后挂网，这也是有一点 lucky 的成分。你看没过，这一局就输了。所以透的都是打，真的是很刚好，很刚好的。哎，这一球出界了吗？哇，这一球出界，哇，球权反复来回耶。这不知道是透的第几次的赛末点了。OK， 透的这个发球。我们看看是不是可以顺利拿下来。我们的 Anna 又上 kitchen 了，哇！ Anna 上 kitchen 真的很有威胁性的。如果他球是有打过去的话，哇哦，哇哦，太有威胁性了。这个就真的是完全接不到的。哇哦！拿回发球权来之后，首度得分，终于来到五分了。啊，那来自Toad自己的挂网，虽然Toad是领先，但是有没有发现打起来的威胁性 ，Anna 还是远远大于Toad的哦。Toad 我觉得他是比较属于稳扎稳打型的，不是属于强势进攻型的， 所以这样的选手呢，如果面对的对手是失误率比较高的话，这样的选手往往能够在长时间的对战中取得优势，因为稳定嘛。但是安娜这个选手呢，她如此有威胁性的打法，如果被她抓到球杆，那太可怕了，那没有人阻止得了她。像透的这种稳定型的呢，就也不见得可以把这种强势型的选手给压制下去。OK， 又轮到我们的 Todd 发球了，这个不知道是第几个赛末点了，现在分数来到10-6，我们来看 Todd 发球。你看他一发完球之后，哇，这一球一抽完球之后，我们的 Anna 就上线了。啊，不好意思，这边讯号有点不好哦，所以这一局没看见发生什么事情，但是可以知道的是，我们 Anna 又拿回发球权了。他这个上 kitchen 的压迫感实在太强大了。好，现在比数来到10-6 ，Anna 发球，哇，这个底线抽球有没有过呢？还是奥欸，我看 Anna 尝试了好几次要压左边底线的抽球，但是都奥。可是你看他奥，他还是一直拼命的这样打哦。你看，其实这一球我从画面上看是硬的。但是 Anna 没有挑战，又轮到 Todd 的赛末点，我觉得他经历超过14赛末点了吧？哇哦，这一球好惊险呢！这一球是打到 out， 不然这一球硬的话也是接不到的。有的时候就是差这么一点点，又回到 Anna 发球了。哇，这一球很轻松，我感觉 Anna 开始渐渐找回球感了，开始轻松打，轻松得分。他前面用力量的打法应该只是为了热身。哇，这一球，你看这个就是我说的哦，你突然上 K 圈，如果另外一边的抽球是很准的话，他往你比较远的地方打，你看你接到球就很容易把球接出界。哇，这个吊短球，然后又吊个长球，哇，漂亮的一回合啊！透的再往前吊个小短球，没想到 Anna 跑到就算了，还可以吊出一个让透的不好接的一个吊球，然后再回击抽右边一个吊转的角度，这一局真的漂亮哦！哇，转眼间已经来到9分了 ，Anna， 太精彩了！哇，这个左右，有点把 Todd 的节奏给打乱了。哇，现在来到10-10哎 ，Pickleball 呢，在后面赛末点的时候来到10-10是要连得两分的，所以现在 Anna 要得到12分。才能够赢哦！我们看 Anna 是不是会继续得分？哇哦，又得分了！画面这个就是 Anna 她妈了哦，就是她当年第一次拿冠军，她的第一个冠军就跟她妈拿的女子双打冠军，也是她人生这一辈子最难忘的冠军。在刚刚前面影片有介绍，所以现在来到11-10，这多不可思议啊！从4分开始追，10-10开始追。哇哦 ，Todd 的这一回合终于打出一点侵略性，上 kitchen 之后左右横移，左右对调，调的 Anna 也是完全没办法去守这一球，然后 Todd 把发球权拿回到自己的手上。好，我们来看 Todd 怎么回应哦，能不能继续扳平呢？如果又打到11分，就会要打到13分才可以赢哦，会不会继续打 deuce 呢？哇，这一球打出界了，所以换 Anna 发球。我们来看看 Todd 怎么迎接 Anna 这一波攻势哦。你看 Anna 又上前了 ，Kitchen 往左打，哇，打高了，轻轻往右掉，哇，太不可思议，逆转了这一局，他自己也大吼了一声，这就是天才美少女 Anna Lee Waters。 想知道台湾最新匹克球的消息，请订阅我们，点赞且打开小铃铛哦。